Listen to me, everybody. Listen up. Getting restless? Let's start the show.
When people think of New York City today, their minds go to shows like Broad City and Girls, as well as the recent films of Noah Baumbach. While they all show the struggles of living in modern-day NYC, it does show a brighter, safer, more welcoming city. An NYC much different than the one shown in Slava Tuskerman's cult classic, Liquid Sky. Released 35 years ago, made for just $500,000, Liquid Sky was one of the most prominent titles of the No Wave movement. No Wave was an underground film movement that began in the late 70s to the mid 80s. It consisted of artists, writers, and musicians who lived in or were a part of the Greenwich Village art scene, who bought and borrowed Super 8 cameras to make their own films. A lot of those films screened at the New Theater in St. Mark's, which is now a vegan place. They were incredibly cheap, filled with people who lived in the village at the time, and as far as getting permits to film, you can forget about it. The biggest name to come out of the movement was Jim Jarmusch, who began his career with Permanent Vacation in 1980 and went on to become one of the most important names in American independent cinema. A lot of what was made during the No Wave movement would not be considered good because of how cheap it was. But even though they didn't have proper lighting or professionally trained actors, there was a rawness there. And those films reflected what the city once was. Tuskerman, a Russian documentarian who came to NYC from Israel in the mid-70s, wanted to capture just that, as well as the creative energy radiating from his adopted home with Liquid Sky. The film follows Margaret, an androgynous bisexual woman who has left her WASPy existence in Connecticut to move to New York with aspirations of becoming a fashion model. Margaret is abused by everyone she comes into contact with. Her nemesis in the scene, Jimmy, her older lover and former teacher, Owen, her roommate, Adrian, and a number of men who forced themselves on her. Unbeknownst to Margaret and everyone else in her life, an alien craft lands on her roof, searching for heroin. What these formless, color-shifting creatures discover is that the pheromones released in the brain through an orgasm are much stronger. They begin to absorb it from the people who sleep with Margaret, killing them. Unaware of what exactly is causing this, Margaret uses her newfound power to rid herself of all the abusive people in her life. The film is notable for its idiosyncratic soundtrack, unique production and costume design, and for the performance of Anne Carlisle, who played both Margaret and Jimmy in a rare move where an actor plays two roles of different genders, something I have only seen done once before. I'm sorry for making you sit through that. The film was the most successful independent release of 1983 and ran for 4 years at the Waverly Theater, now the location of the IFC Center in the West Village. Until a recent restoration, it was almost impossible to see the film. However, even though it's just getting rediscovered, the film has had a lasting impact, being seen as the inspiration behind electroclash, music that merged the new wave sounds of the 80s, with 90s techno. While the No Wave movement is long behind us, and I couldn't tell you where to get a Super 8 camera these days, you do have something in your pocket right now that you can whip out any time and start making your own movie. No training, no actors, no permits, no rules. Sound familiar?